Hello everyone, I'm Sarah of Rich Textures Crochet and welcome. Today we're going to learn how to make the Star-Crossed Beanie, which is the second crochet beanie in the Wonderful Hats Crochet Along 2022. This is the crochet beanie that we'll be making here today. This is I've listed as an intermediate pattern because of the variety of stitches in it, but it is a fairly easy beanie to work once you know these stitches. So hopefully this video tutorial will help you along. This beanie is sized for an adult, as will be worked in this video. It measures approximately 8.5 by 9 inches laid flat with a 21 to 23 inch circumference. I'll give you some instruction a little bit later on how to adjust the pattern if needed. For the design today, you're going to need a worsted weight yarn. We'll be working with the Color Theory yarn in the Canyon color by Two of Wands and Lion Brand. This is a little bit on the lighter end as far as a worsted weight yarn is concerned, so keep that in mind as you are looking for a substitute, if you are. You're going to need one ball. Each ball has about 246 yards of yarn. Now this, I did not include a pom-pom on the top of my beanie, but you're welcome to as well. It does look great with or without one. You're also going to need a 4.5 millimeter crochet hook and a copy of the free written pattern, which is on richtexturescrochet.com. So thank you so much for joining me. While you're here, I invite you to subscribe. Take a look around. The free matching crochet scarf pattern will be coming out in a couple of days, so be sure to check that out, as well as the other beanie patterns as they arrive for the crochet along. Our star-crossed beanie today is worked from the brim up, and a couple of notes on the brim. I'll actually bring my sample back up here. I have worked an extra long slip stitch brim here so that I can fold it up and just make it a little bit more cozy and warm for wearing. It's really up to you. So I'll give you some stitch counts in a little bit as far as how to shorten it if you wanted to just have a shorter brim instead of the fold up. A couple of other notes. I like to work slip stitch brims for my hats, but if you would like to substitute your slip stitches for single crochet or half double crochet, you're welcome to do that as well. So for our brim, we're going to start by making a slip knot. It will be worked in rows, and we're going to chain a foundation chain. If you would like the folded up brim, as I have done, I recommend chaining 26. If you would rather it not be folded up, you're going to want to chain about 13 chains, and you can change it as far as how high or short you would like your brim. There's 10. And 26. So once you have the chain for your brim the desired length, we're going to begin working a slip stitch into the second chain from your hook. Now I like working into these back bumps, but it doesn't matter too much. You can work according to your own preference. So slip stitch into the second chain from your hook, and then slip stitch into each chain all the way across. Once you come all the way across, we're going to chain one and turn your work. For row two of your brim, looking at the tops of your stitches, you have your front loop and your back loop. So the back loop is this horizontal bar that's the furthest away from you. So at the top of your stitch, you have your front loop and your back loop. For our next row, and the rows here after for the brim, we're going to work in that back loop only. So inserting your hook in the back loop only, we're going to slip stitch in the first stitch. The chain one does not count as a stitch. And then slip stitch into each stitch all the way across, always working in that back loop. At the end of your row, you're going to chain one, turn your work, and repeat this row two until your work from the beginning measures 16 to 17 inches,
or until it fits your head comfortably. So the 16 to 17 inches is without stretch. So when it stretches, it should reach that adult circumference, ranging 20 to 23 inches. So go ahead, repeat row 2 until your work from the beginning measures 16 to 17 inches, and then meet me back here. Once you have your brim so that you've worked 16 to 17 inches, when the fabric is relaxed, you'll have a piece that looks like this with quite a bit of stretch to it. We're then going to crochet our two short ends together. So at the end, you can chain one, and you're going to fold over the brim of your hat so that the two short ends meet. We're now going to, working through the back loops of both thicknesses, work a slip stitch all the way across, always being sure to match the stitches. You don't want to skip any or work twice in any of these stitches. So you're working in the back loop only of the first piece and the back loop only of the second piece, and slip stitch. You're going to do that all the way across your brim, and it's going to create a nice seam for our hat. All the way up the side. I have just a few stitches left, making sure once again not to skip any. Once you come all the way up to the top, you will not fasten off, and instead you're going to turn your brim so that you're working along this long rough edge. If you have worked the long brim, we're going to leave it inside out. If you've worked a short brim that you're not going to fold over, then you're going to want to turn it so that the right side is facing you. But if you're working this long brim, don't worry about turning it inside out. You're then going to chain one, and we're going to work a round of half double crochet stitches all the way around. We are going to, for the adult pattern, work 84 half double crochet stitches, just inserting your hook wherever you feel it's comfortable around the brim. You want to try and space these stitches out fairly evenly though. So if it helps, place a stitch marker about halfway around, work half your stitches on one side and half your stitches on the other. If you would like to change the size of your beanie, you're going to need a multiple of 3 stitches for this first round of your Star-Crossed Beanie. Once you have worked 84 half double crochet stitches all the way around, you're going to join with a slip stitch into your first stitch. Your chain one does not count as a stitch, so you're just joining in that half double crochet. You're then ready to start some of the star design in our pattern. What we're going to do is we're going to start by working a beginning star stitch, and we're going to chain three. Once you have chained three, to work the beginning star stitch, you're going to insert your hook into the second chain from your hook, yarn over and drop a loop. You're going to do that into the next chain on your hook, that first chain, yarn over and draw up a loop. You'll have three loops on your hook. Next, you want to insert your hook into the base of your chain, so into the same stitches joining of that half double crochet round. Insert your hook, yarn over, drop a loop. Four loops on your hook. Insert your hook into the next stitch, the next half double crochet. Yarn over and drop a loop. Insert your hook into the next stitch one more time. Yarn over and draw up a loop. You'll have six loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all six loops and chain one. That's your beginning star stitch. We're now going to continue working star stitches all the way around. To work your next full star stitch, you're going to insert your hook into the chain one, so into the center of your stitch, of your previous star stitch. Yarn over and drop a loop. Next, you're going to insert your hook under the first or the last post of the previous star stitch. And I'm just inserting my hook under the one loop. Yarn over and draw up a loop. Next, insert your hook into the base, the same space, the same stitch as the last star stitch. Yarn over and drop a loop. Into the next half double crochet, insert your hook, yarn over and drop a loop. And one more time, insert your hook into the next stitch, yarn over and draw up a loop. Once again, you'll have six stitches on your hook, yarn over and pull through all six and chain one. Continue working star stitches all the way around. Insert into the chain one, yarn over, drop a loop. Insert your hook into the last leg of the last star stitch, yarn over, drop a loop. Into the base, the stitch at the base of your star stitch, yarn over, drop a loop. Into the next half double crochet, and then into the next. Six loops on your hook, yarn over, pull through all six, and chain one. Continue working all the way around until you come to your final star stitch. As you come all the way around working your star stitches, you will come to the end and you'll have one stitch remaining. We are going to work one more star stitch over this one star, over this one remaining stitch. So just as you did before, insert through the center, through the final leg, through the base of your previous star stitch, then into the next stitch, and then into the same stitch as joining for the next star stitch. You'll have six loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all six loops. Chain one and join with a slip stitch into that first star stitch. We're now going to slip stitch into the center, into the first chain one of the first star stitch. Now for round two, we're going to chain one and work two single crochet stitches into the center of each star stitch all the way around. At the end of that round two for your star stitches, you'll have a total of 42 stars. So now we're working two single crochet stitches, both into the center of each star, and we're going to do that all the way around. So there's the one center, into the next chain stitch, center of the next star, work two single crochet stitches. repeat that all the way around. And when you come to your first single crochet, join with a slip stitch into that first stitch. Once you come all the way around, you work your final two single crochet stitches into the final chain stitch. You will once again have a total of 84 stitches, and you're going to join with a slip stitch into the first stitch. For round four, we're going to chain four, and this will count as a double crochet stitch and a chain one. We're now going to continue working some of our texture, and by working crossed double crochet stitches. This first crossed double crochet stitch is a little bit trickier than the rest in the round, in the sense that this is the double crochet, this is your chain one. We now want to, kind of pinching back that double crochet, yarn over, we're going to skip the previous stitch. So we have this stitch that our chain four is coming out of, we have this stitch right before it, and then into the next stitch, the next previous stitch, we're going to work a double crochet stitch. So we're kind of working backward here. So two stitches back, yarn over, insert your hook. You're going to work around that post of that first chain stitch, yarn over, drop a loop, yarn over and pull through two, and yarn over and pull through two more. It looks a little bit congested, but if you pull up the chain a little bit, you can see that X coming through. And when we come all the way around, we're going to work in that stitch, which is going to pull it out even more. So this counts as your first crossed double crochet. We're then going to work cross double crochet stitches all the way around. So skip the next two stitches, not including the one that your chain four comes out of. So there's one and two. Yarn over, work a double crochet into the next stitch. Chain one. Now working over top of that double crochet and into the first skipped stitch, work a double crochet. So bring your hook back into that first skip stitch, yarn over, drop a loop, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over and pull through two. That's your second cross double crochet. You're going to continue working cross double crochet stitches all the way around. Skip the next two stitches, double crochet in the next stitch, chain one, double crochet back into that first skipped stitch, working around the post of the previous double crochet. Continue to repeat those all the way around. When you come all the way around, you've worked your final cross double crochet, you're going to join with a slip stitch into the third chain of that starting chain four. So you may need to pull that chain up a little bit once again, but into that third chain of the starting chain four, join with a slip stitch into your first stitch. You can then chain one. We're now going to work another round of single crochet stitches, starting with this third chain. The same stitches joining, work a single crochet. Single crochet into the chain one space, and then work a single crochet in each of the next two double crochet stitches of your cross double crochets. Single crochet in the chain one space, and then single crochet in each of the next two double crochet stitches. You're going to repeat that all the way around. When you come to your first stitch, join with a slip stitch into the top of your first stitch. At the end of round five, you've worked a single crochet in your final double crochet. join with a slip stitch into that first stitch. We have now reached the end of the repeat for our pattern. So what we're going to do is we're now going to repeat rounds 2, 3, 4, and 5 twice more. So your round 2 was that beginning star stitch, followed by working star stitches all the way around, and then your single crochet round, and your cross double crochet round, followed by the other single crochet round. So you're going to repeat rows 2, 3, 4, and 5 twice more, and then you can meet me back here and we will start the decrease of our hats. Once you come all the way around, you'll have come and finish your repeats. You'll be at the end of round 13, which ends with a single crochet round following your double crochet cross double crochet stitches. So this is what your work looks like from the beginning. You're then ready to begin the decrease rounds for your hat. These are worked very simply. You're going to chain one, half double crochet in each of the next 10 stitches. This is for round 14. So starting with the same stitches joining, six, seven, eight, nine, and then 10. And you're then going to half double crochet 2 stitches together. So yarn over, insert your hook in the next stitch, yarn over and drop a loop, insert your hook into the next stitch, yarn over and draw up a loop, 4 loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through all 4. That's your half double crochet 2 together. You're then going to repeat that all the way around. 1 half double crochet in each of the next 10 stitches. And then half double crochet 2 stitches together. When you come all the way around, join with a slip stitch into the top of your first stitch. When you come all the way around, at the end of round 14, join with a slip stitch in the first stitch and chain 1. For round 15, we're going to half double crochet in each of the next 9 stitches. So there's 1, 2, 8, and 9. And then half double crochet 2 stitches together. You're going to repeat that all the way around. 1 half double crochet in each of the next 9 stitches. And half double crochet 2 stitches together. Repeat all the way around and join with a slip stitch in your first stitch. At the end of round 15, you'll have joined with a slip stitch in that first stitch. You'll have a total of 70 stitches at the end of round 15. For round 16, chain 1. We're going to half double crochet in each of the next 8 stitches. Then half double crochet 2 stitches together. Repeat that all the way around, half double crochet in each of the next 8 stitches. and then half double crochet, two stitches together. Repeat all the way around and join with a slip stitch into your first stitch. At the end of round 16, join with a slip stitch into the top of your first stitch, and you will have a total of 63 stitches. You're then going to chain one. For round 17, half double crochet in each of the next seven stitches. And half double crochet, two stitches together. We're going to repeat that, one half double crochet in each of the next seven stitches. And half double crochet, two stitches together. Repeat all the way around and join with a slip stitch in the first stitch. At the end of round 17, you'll join with a slip stitch into your first stitch, and at the end of this round, you'll have a total of 56 stitches. For round 18, chain one, half double crochet in each of the next six stitches. And half double crochet, two stitches together. We're going to repeat that all the way around, half double crochet in each of the next six stitches. And half double crochet, two stitches together. Repeat all the way around and join with a slip stitch into the top of your first stitch. At the end of round 18, you'll join with a slip stitch in your first stitch, and you'll have a total of 49 stitches. For round 19, chain one, half double crochet in each of the next five stitches. And then half double crochet, two stitches together. Repeat that, half double crochet in each of the next five stitches. And half double crochet, two stitches together. When you come all the way around, join with a slip stitch into the top of your first stitch. At the end of round 19, you've joined with a slip stitch into your first stitch, chain one. You'll have a total of 42 stitches. For round 20, we're going to half double crochet into our first stitch and into each of the next three stitches. So for a total of four. And then half double crochet, two stitches together. Half double crochet in each of the next four stitches. And half double crochet, two stitches together. Repeat that all the way around and join with a slip stitch into your first stitch. At the end of round 20, you'll have a total of 35 stitches. Join with a slip stitch into the first stitch. For round 21, half double crochet in each of the next three stitches. And half double crochet, two stitches together. Repeat that all the way around. Half double crochet in each of the next three stitches. and half double crochet two stitches together. Join with a slip stitch in the top of your first stitch. At the end of round 21, you'll have a total of 28 stitches. You've joined with a slip stitch in your first stitch. Chain one. For round 22, you will probably have guessed it, you're going to half double crochet in each of the next two stitches. And then half double crochet two stitches together. Repeat that, half double crochet in each of the next two stitches. And half double crochet two stitches together. You're going to repeat that all the way around and then join with a slip stitch in your first stitch. For round 23, we're going to chain one, half double crochet into the next stitch, and then half double crochet two stitches together. We're going to repeat that all the way around, half double crochet into the next stitch, followed by a half double crochet two stitches together. At the end of this round, you'll only have 14 stitches remaining. I'm going to keep working here all the way around. At the end of that round 23, join with a slip stitch into the top of your first stitch. For your final round, round 24, you're simply going to half double crochet two stitches together all the way around. And at the end of this round, you're only going to have seven stitches. One stitch remaining here. When you come all the way around, join with a slip stitch into the top of your first stitch, and you're then going to fasten off, and you can leave a little bit of a long tail. Then, in order to finish off your beanie nicely, you're going to take a yarn needle, thread that long tail through the yarn needle, and then when I'm sewing the top of my hat closed, I like to turn the hat inside out. You're then going to take that long tail and your yarn needle and simply weave the tail in and out through the top stitches around the top of your hat. When you've come all the way around, you're simply then going to pull the top of the hat closed, and then I like to secure it with a knot. You're then going to tuck in your tail . Trim it off, Turn your hat right side out again. Fold your brim if necessary. And that is your star-crossed beanie. Once again, you can add a pom-pom to the top if you'd like. Otherwise, it looks great without. So thank you so much for joining me. And once again, I invite you to subscribe, take a look around, and keep an eye open for the star-crossed scarf, which will be coming soon. Until then, happy crocheting. Bye.